Hey, back with another video. Today we'll be talking about Tailwind CSS 2.0. Tailwind just released a version 2.0 a couple days ago. Now here's the new tailwindcss.com website. They've revamped everything, made everything a lot bigger, kind of showcase what this 2.0 is all about. If you have time, go take a look at it. I'm going to go into this get started area. And I think they kind of outline the new version or what's new about it in here a little bit better. They have this what's new in Tailwind in this section. They got this new focus ring. So I guess a new kind of styling for their buttons. They introduced dark mode, which is pretty cool there. I guess there's two ways to do it. There's a automated way. If you set up in your OS dark mode, or light mode, it'll choose one or the other. And there's also a way to toggle it with a CSS class. They've extended the color palettes as well, so there's more colors. I'm not sure if this is such a big deal because you could always just create your own color palette yourself. Extend variant. I guess there's more of these now. So there's first, last, odd. Okay, that's all right. And there's a new extra wide breakpoint, shareable presets. I guess they made this so you can create extra like config files or preset files, and you can import them into your config file to make it a little bit more modular. There's gradients, which I think they seem to be the same. I don't know if there's very much different for there. Maybe somebody that knows can leave a comment down below. And animations, which I think they also had, but maybe they've added new ones. Ping, pulsing, bounce. Let's go and take a look at the install. And see what the difference is. I'm going to go here. Let's go ahead and make dir. I'm going to do tailwind. Dash v2, cd into that, open up code.vscode. I have VS Code open. Let's open up terminal here and take a look at how do we install Tailwind now and see how it's changed. npm install tailwind css post css auto prefixer. Previously we kind of only needed this, I guess. If we're using PostCSS, and they added this as well, make it a little bit more default that way to use PostCSS, because I think a lot of the front end frameworks use PostCSS, like Vue's, UCLI. I think a React app also does it, but you can't add plugins to PostCSS through React. Well, at least not. Officially, I think you can kind of hack it. I don't think that's how they want it to work anyways. All right, let's get started here. Let's go npm init dash y. Now that created our package, let's go and install some stuff. Clear. And let's close this. Let's grab this, npm install. And I want to install a couple more packages here. Let's do PostCSS CLI, CSS Nano, and OnChange for watching. Let's install that. And if you've seen my other video on how to install Tailwind CSS, we've used these packages before. If you're new, then great as well. Okay, that's done installing. Let's clear that. So next step, postcss.config and tailwindcss.config or tailwind.config.js. Okay, we can do that by, let's kill two birds with one stone. You can do npx and you can do dash p. This will create both of our files for us. Let's go ahead and configure this first. Now, I want to do this mode. Layers. Because I think if you don't put that in, it gives us some kind of deprecated error. Content. And we'll look at ./public. We haven't created this file yet, or this folder yet. Okay, so we're gonna look, we're gonna look for all the HTML files within our public directory, and we haven't created that yet. We'll do that in a sec. Let's go into post CSS config. We have in here using post CSS as your preprocessor, and I like this a little bit more. I'm going to grab that. We're not using this. And we're going to need to include rec CSS nano. I'm going to include that here. And what we're going to do here is do default preset default. And that looks all good. Delete that. Oops. All right, let's create our CSS file, our source CSS file. Clear this. Make dir. And we'll need source. We'll make dir. We'll need CSS. Touch source CSS tailwind.css. Now we have all this. And we just need to post, go back to here, and grab these. And that's our source CSS file. Let's go and create some scripts within our package. Get rid of that. Clear that, and we'll do tdub build. Tailwind CSS build. We're going to do slash source slash CSS slash tailwind CSS dash O for output dot slash public. We haven't created this directory yet. Tailwind dot CSS. Okay, let's save that. I think that's all correct. Let's go and try it out. npm run tailwind build. And it looks like it's good. And it should create this pathway for us. Public CSS tailwind CSS. Built it using 3.74 megs. Let's create another. We'll do watch. What we need here is on change. And we're going to watch this file. And we're going to watch all CSS files within source. And we're going to use this npm run tdub build. So I think that's it. Let's save that. Need a comma here. Yeah, I just didn't like that. Now let's go and run this script. npm watch. Okay, so it's watching these two files. This file and this file, because I only have one CSS file. Let's add some colors. And do CWC. And I got red. Blue and gray. And I got some colors here. I'll just paste these in. And I got this 222222. Save that. It watched it, so it's building it right now. And it's built. And let's also do something here. Code. And we'll do at apply text PWC red. Okay, as that's building, let's go take a look. That created that style for here, and it automatically built our CSS file from the source. What else do we need to search for? Let's do CWC. And there's 66 different classes with CWC. We have red, blue, and gray. Okay, throughout. So it's using the color palette theme. Okay, let's exit out of that. Okay, let's go and create a text file or index file. We'll leave that watching. Okay, touch. Text.html. Create that. And let's do doc for, and we'll have this emit abbreviation in our boilerplate for HTML. To Tailwind CSS 2.0. Let's add our link CSS in Tailwind. Let's add some, let's do div. This will be class. We'll do another div. We'll do H1 and PTAG. Class equals. And here I'll do flex, justify center, and items center. And we'll do a height screen. And I'm going to do padding 20. Text center. Here I'll do text 9XL. So they've increased the text size. I think 6 was what it was before, XL. And here I'll do Tailwind CSS 2.0 is now here. Let's serve this up and see if it's working. And let's go full screen. Tailwind CSS 2.0 is now here. That's how you install Tailwind CSS 2.0. Let's take a look at how we can serve it up as production. So we haven't purged our CSS. Our file is still pretty big right now. Okay, let's take a look here. We need this. Grab this. Actually, this one. And that. Prod. Replace this with post CSS, and this is using our post CSS CLI. Now we need to add this kind of this down here. Where is it? This node environment production. So this is the variable to tell it that it's going for production, and that will signal it to use this for the purge. Otherwise, the Tailwind CSS doesn't use purge unless it is specified here using this variable here. Hopefully my post CSS has no errors because we haven't run it yet. Every time we've built it, it's using just the regular Tailwind build. In this one, we're actually using the post CSS. Okay, let's go and run tw prod. Build that. So it looks like it's built. Let's go to another tab. Let's go to cd public css ls-la. We'll see that it has the size is 1 byte in size. If we go and check it out, this is what we have. All right. Hold on a sec. Let me make it so it's. So this is what our CSS looks like now. It's been purged and minified. Now let's check out over here to see if this has changed at all. Well, let's serve it back up. Okay, so that is now not working. Let's try it. Let's check our public. Problem because of this. Okay, let's try serving it up again. npm run production. There was an error in my kind of my expression here for the content. Okay, let's go add a couple of custom classes. We had CWC, our text CWC, and I'll do red. And I'll do text CWC blue. NPM run. Doesn't have those classes anymore. We got our red and blue classes showing up now. That's pretty much it for installing and setting up Tailwind CSS 2.0. And it's not very much different than the 1.0. Let's go to our script or our package file just to check it out. We have our npm scripts here. I think the build script here is the same as my 1.0 build script. Nothing's really changed there. The watch script is a little bit different. I'm now watching all CSS files in the source folder, just because I think they're trying to push more of the modular CSS, modular config. So I want to be able to watch that. There's probably something I'd probably do with presets here, maybe in the future, maybe add another folder like this. The production script, I think this will actually work in later versions of version 1, where it's using the node environment production. But in the earlier versions, maybe not. So this hasn't really changed if you're used to the newer versions of version 1. But if you're used to older versions of version 1, this might be a little bit different. But it's a good change. It makes it easier to purge out your CSS. Key takeaways, there's a couple new features. Looks like there's more capabilities to build out more modularly. More pseudo classes, dark mode now. Give Tailwind a try. Test out the new features. Let me know what you think. That's it for setting up and installing Tailwind CSS version 2, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video.